In this tutorial, I'm going to show you the proof of the derivative of x to the fourth power. First, I'm going to show you the graph and then also work out all the algebra for you as well. I'll plot x on the x-axis, obviously, and y on the y-axis. And the graph of x to the fourth power looks like this. If I pick a point, x, and the associated y value would be x to the fourth, f of x is equal to x to the fourth power. If I add h to the x, I have a new point, and that's x plus h, right there. And the associated y value will be x plus h to the fourth power. If I have 2 points on this function, and I want to calculate the slope of the line or estimate it, I can draw a straight line like that. But the problem is there's an error right there. If I let the distance of h approach 0, those points get closer and closer together. As I move those points closer together and draw a straight line through those 2 points, like that, h, or the distance, becomes smaller and smaller. Also, the error that I would have by estimating a straight line versus a curved line is smaller too. As those points get closer together, and I draw another straight line, the error gets smaller and smaller. You can hardly even see it now. If those points get even closer together and approach 0, the distance between them is 0, I create what is known as a tangent line. And this is the idea behind a lot of calculus, especially derivatives. Now I'll put all the points back to where they were. Hopefully, like that. Now I'm going to calculate the slope of this brown line. And if you recall, the slope is equal to rise over run. Rise is this distance here, and run is the horizontal distance. So the slope of that brown line is rise over run. And I'll work that out for you algebraically now. Rise is x plus h to the fourth power minus x to the fourth power. And the run is x plus h minus x. The denominator is actually going to be h, but I'm going to leave it like this for now. Let me move this so I have a little bit more space. Notice these two x's cancel out, so I'm left with just h. And I have x plus h to the fourth power, which is x plus h times x plus h times x plus h times x plus h minus x to the fourth, divided by h. At the end of this video, after you see the red Party More, Study Less, I show you all the algebra in a lot of detail of how you get to this next step, which is right here. All this minus x to the fourth power. Divided by h. Notice these two x to the fourth powers cancel out. H here, I have h here, h here, h here. And I have it down here. So I'm going to factor h out of the numerator. So I have h times all this. Right there. All this times h. Divided by h. These two h's cancel out. I'm left with all of this. As h approaches 0, I can write this as 4x cubed plus all this other stuff times 0. And I can ignore all these. That one too, and this last one right here. So the answer is 4x cubed. So formally, I would write this as, I'd move over the equal sign up here, and I'd write limit of x approaches 0 is equal to 4x cubed, like that. Let me check my answer using the power rule. I take that 4, bring it in front, and multiply it times everything, like that. Minus 1 is equal to 4 times x to the third power. And Bob's your uncle. There you go. Share the knowledge, share the love, Facebook. All that algebra stuff's coming up, so you might want to watch, check out that algebra. Subscribe, like. But here comes the algebra. Wait for it. Here it is right here.